Hey, I'm here with Lance Brahman, Coach Noah Lyles. Came out here today. How's it feel to kind of, for Noah to rub the specialist nose in it a little bit? At least that's what we all kind of see.
Yeah, I mean, I don't look at it that way. I see it as we came in here, we've been working on some things. You know, obviously his start needs to get better. You know, honestly, we need to be a 9.7 type guy in 100 meters if he's going to have a shot of breaking his world record in the two. He wants to do the double, so that's what it takes. So that's the direction training is going in and the type of stuff we're working on. And for him to do that, the first 60 needs to set up better. So there's been a little bit of concentration in it, but not neglecting what we normally do. So it's
right.
It's going well. We're going to run a couple more. But it's truly for the purpose of I need him in a better position at 60 meters and 100.
Awesome.
And that's what we're working on.
How does it feel, or how hard is it as a coach to work with an athlete who just broke an American record and get him excited, you know, to move forward and keep going? Or is Noah pretty easy at doing that?
It's never even been a conversation. I mean, he broke the American record. In his mind, that's what he wanted to do. It was an expectation of his and mine. We thought he had a chance going in. Now we move on and make the next step.
When you're setting up a season to perform well at the end at the World Championships or the Olympic Games, how do you look at indoor track and how it fits into y'all's plan?
I really don't change much training-wise. I do a little bit just because, you know, if you're going to race, you need to at least have a little bit of legs underneath of you to get it in. But, you know, we're still training. We're still doing, you know, 300s. We're doing stuff around the track. You know, the whole purpose is if you're going to run indoors, there needs to be a reason. It needs to be a purpose. And it needs to be a part of the process. And, you know, for him and everybody that I have racing, number one, we're working on something. No matter who it is, there's a reason that we're doing it. And two, you know, it breaks up the monotony of just training every day and not, you know, we look at races as dessert. Occasionally you need to give them a little dessert because the meat and potatoes happen during the week.
Well said, Coach. Well, hey, we really appreciate you taking time to talk to us.
Not a word.